From Seth Doane in Italy, some notes from the underground.
The displays at this nerve center may rattle a few as they monitor the increasing volcanic activity around Naples, Italy, including a magnitude 4.0 just 2 days ago.
The red is all earthquakes. These are all earthquakes of the last week.
Yes.
We were there in March. There had been around 2,000 earthquakes in February alone. Most are so small they do not make news.
The sensitivity of our network is very, very high.
But still warrant the attention of National Institute of Geophysics and Volcanology Director Mauro De Vito.
Is my telephone
it means calls at any time.
Generally during night.
Among the volcanoes within his remit is one with quite a reputation, Mount Vesuvius. That, of course, infamously covered the city of Pompeii in ash nearly 2,000 years ago.
And here you see with Vesuvius, everything
is
in one place.
It's all concentrated in the central, in the crater area.
But just 30 miles from Vesuvius, there's a much more complex volcanic structure, which today is demanding more attention. Campi Flegrei stretches 125 miles under urban areas and out into the Bay of Naples. It's often called Europe's most dangerous volcano.
The risk is very high due to the high density of population here. Population within the caldera.
It's literally like living on a volcano.
Yes, in.
In a
within
volcano.
Within a volcano.
But how can that be? How can people be permitted to live in a volcano?
The reasons are many. We can found traces of the life from 10,000 years.
In modern times, about 500,000 people live in the red zone, which is most at risk of eruption. This fuming area is the center of it, called Solfatara, which government scientist Giovanni Macedonio reminded us is now off limits to visitors.
You see the steam, you can smell the sulfur, and this tells you it's not so calm, not so tranquil under the ground.
Yeah, we know that under the ground there is a place, a volume, that is heated from fluids that come from below, from the magma chamber.
While magma under Mount Vesuvius has a more predictable path to the surface, Campi Flegrei has a more complex plumbing system. Deep underground, it's a snarl after massive eruptions thousands of years ago mangled the Earth's crust. There are huge pools of magma and hundreds of pathways to the surface. What's happening here is a geological phenomenon called bradycism, which is also seen at Yellowstone, a national park, not an urban area.
So the land is actually moving up and down?
Moving up and down.
To see the cyclical rise and fall caused by volcanic activity, Macedonio took us to the port of Pozzuoli.
This is not the tide changing, this is the land lifted.
The land that lifted about more than 2 meters here.
Marco Marotta has a restaurant here. Until 5-6 years ago, the water level was much higher, he told us.
Veramente diverso rispetto oggi, really different from today.
Yeah, molto, molto diverso.
Yes, really different, he said. Before there were boats, there were fishermen. Now it's no longer a port, it's become a pond. It's the opposite effect from centuries ago when this area was slowly sinking. To see that, we suited up a while back for 60 minutes plus. Dive down and explore the now sunken ancient city of Baia. It had been a seaside retreat for the wealthiest Romans. These stairs once likely led to the water. Today, they're submerged, and underwater archaeologists are working to restore mosaics.
We see gas, water, and all this generates these rivers of mud that we can see from here.
Today, the opposite is happening, an uplift, as Giovanni Macedonio explained.
During the sinking, there is very few gas activity. And the contrary, when there is uplift, we see earthquakes and also increasing in the gassing.
That degassing is one potential warning sign. Italy's government is monitoring the smallest of movements.
This is the passage of a train.
Which means more phone calls.
Ah, sorry.
To Mauro Di Vito.
Do the signs worry you?
When I see increase in the activity, earthquakes, increase of gas emission, of course, those are important parameters.
Potential warning signs.
Yes, but something can change tomorrow. My feeling is, of course, that the volcano is in an increasing unrest.
Increasing unrest.
Increasing unrest.
Now, today.
Now, but this can also finish. But now we do not have evidences of a possible eruption.
It's not possible to predict an eruption, so they're monitoring gases and watching for warning signs which would trigger evacuation orders. For now, the many tiny earthquakes are just a reminder of the power bubbling below.